Oh.
I got a strange feeling that something just ain't well.
Bro. Check out what I found. What a dope album, man. It's cool, dude. It's blues. Strictly, sounds like. Bought this bad boy for $22. Because why wouldn't it cost that much? And I was like, God, I've never heard of whatever the fuck this is. Never heard of it. So I had to buy it. For some reason, the chick had a sticker on it that said 1987. And I'm like, oh, okay. Maybe it's an 80s, if it's from 87, maybe it's like a metal album or something, is what I thought. So I listened to it. I said, okay, let's just check this out, let's listen to it. We're not gonna look inside of it, we're gonna play the music first and stare at the cover. Dude. And what's really cool too, is obviously... Yeah, I know. That's why I was like, what the fuck is this? And then I opened it up. I'm like, this is 60s. This is 69, I believe. Oh, look what they're playing, man. Look at that bass. Yeah. Dude, this is tight. This is exactly why you search for realness, man. This is exactly why what the digital era misses. Like, I walked in there, I didn't expect to buy records, saw a record collection, saw a bunch of Beatles albums, classics from the 60s in there. $60, some of them. And they were the real Beatle albums from the 60s. And I was looking through them all, and I was like, well, I have them. And then I just saw this. And I was like, dude, you can't. And that's what it's about. It's not about a release and a fucking trailer and this and that. It's about seeing something like this and saying, what is this? And listening to it objectively. And asking yourself, what's in that album? You know how much of a shocker it was to hear blues coming out of this album? It was a shocker.
Oh.
inside job. You got to go.
Shit, man. Until next time. What an awesome, awesome experience that was. I forgot about that. You get so caught up in the modern era, man. You forget, like, that's how you live life, dude. That's how you find things. Little chilly. Just a wee bit. Gotta keep my hair out of my face, too. And play. So that was pretty cool, man. It was really cool. That was an experience that I like I was saying, man, we forget to do that. Because, man, when you got the digital technology, it's like so easy just to go on YouTube and just type in a band that you think you might have heard of. Or type in some lyrics and see where that gets you, I guess. You know, and it makes things easier, but at the same time, it makes things not as fun to find. That was cool. Very cool, man. It's kind of how I stumbled upon Klaatu. I don't know how to pronounce the name of that band. Klaatu. Sure, everyone's heard of it by now. Really interesting band. Really cool. Little Neutrinos? Is that what that song is called? That's probably one of my favorites by them. On that album. That initial album of theirs. That was really, really good. So yeah, I made sure I listened to front to back of that whole Savory Brown album. Front to back before I even figured out who they were. I did that and I just stared at the cover. And then after the album was over, then I opened it up. And I was like, oh my God. This is, I mean, obviously as soon as I heard it, I was like, this is 60s. This is not 87. This doesn't even sound like 87. The recording, the way the recording sounded, not like he could, his instruments are different. But, yeah, I heard that, I was like, this is totally something straight out of the 60s, maybe late 60s, and yeah, it was 69, so it was kind of cool. And, yeah, after the album, then I looked it up, and I learned a little bit about them and their other albums. Dude, their album art, whoever they get for their album art is amazing. I love the creepy vibes to it. It's so fucking cool, dude. So fucking cool. I love it. I love it. So yeah, that's kind of made me think, like, man, once I can get out to the record shop, store, whatever. Thankfully, I live closer to Ann Arbor because that's not around here, records. It kind of, oh, by the way, when I get there, I'm going to check out some stuff like that. But the thing about it is, with records, I mean, like they once said, you're getting the real sound. I'm getting it recorded on a record, playing it without any digital bullshittery, and it's the real music. And the funny thing is, the second side of that album is actually a live performance, and it sounds so good. Not only are they really tight, like musically and stuff like this, oh, sonically. But oh my God, the recording behind it sounds flawless. It sounds so good. Check it out, man. You should check it out. I recommend you get a record player, man. I think I got the one I showed for like 100 and something bucks. Maybe 130. Not really that much. It's called One by One or some shit. One for one, one by one. You could be that douchebag that's like, the tech audiophile who is like, you gotta get a $4,000 machine to play it like that. Yeah. You could be that guy, and I'm sure there's merits to it. But from what I've heard, it's not much of a difference. It's if you have a palate for it. But I recommend getting a record player. I mean, you could find them everywhere. I saw one from the 70s, a couple, in that same place. I bought that album for 50 bucks or under. So get a good record player. Get the older, the better, sometimes. And grab an album, dude, and just listen to it. Shut your mind up, listen to it, and stare at the cover. I mean, that's what it was for. I mean, I've heard so many stories of how people would perceive the music like that, and they would stare at the cover and listen to it. And it's true. It's really true. It's kind of like the experience you're supposed to have with it. It's a visual looking at it, and it's the sound that comes to you and stuff like that. It's supposed to invoke something. Because I think the secrecy behind who are these guys, what's going on, who is this, is part of it. And what gets ruined is typing in Google and finding out everything you need to know about the band. Like, it ruins it. Mystery's gone. We all love a good mystery. And so I really think that's what you gotta do with your music, man. You gotta make it a secret. Not really a secret, but you gotta, like, present, like, whatever that is. And you don't need a fucking Reddit, or what is it called? What's that called? Twitter. You don't need a guy to have a Twitter account and fucking all that bullshit. That's stupid. If you have to try that hard to keep people invested in you, then fuck them. You know what I mean? Those are just casual fans anyway that wear your Metallica t-shirt. I love Metallica. I listened to 3 of their songs on the Black Album. Or, you know what I mean? Or from Reload. Like, no. It's fine. You know? Don't worry about those people. It kind of got me feeling the music's like that. And like I said, that's very blues. I mean, that's just a blues album. These English guys playing blues. I think they're English. I don't know. They might not be. I mean, it was recorded in London from what I saw. So they might not be, but I'm going to take a guess and say that they're English. Ooh, that's a good thin pick. I'll use that. So that's kind of cool. And, you know, I never really was into blues so much. I get it. I understand what blues has done. But that was the first time I really sat down and listened to that 60s blues. That someone that was trying to stay true to it, like Clapton in the early days. Just stay true to the blues kind of thing. And the song Train to Nowhere. What a cool fucking song that is. That song was weird. Until, like, when I first heard it, I was like, that's weird in a really good way. And I have to listen to that again and again and again. I think I listened to it like 5 times already. I got the album yesterday around this time. So yeah, it's... Wow, dude. It's really cool. It's a really cool album. I think you should get it. The album's called Blue Matter by Savory Brown. You guys. Yeah. Other cool bands like that. That's kind of what I'm into. Look at, he doesn't have music in the background. That's kind of what I'm into. I don't know about King Crimson as much right now. I knew that they existed, but I never gave them a shot yet. It's kind of those popularity things. But I love 60s, 70s weird stuff. That's kind of my favorite music. Like, my favorite Beatle album is probably Magical Mystery Tour. It's probably my favorite Beatle album out of all of them. I love that album. You got some great fucking songs on there. I love weird music from that era. Nowadays, not so much. There's songs that might be cool, but I love weird music. I love strange guitar tone and, like, weird melodies and, like, haunting things and like, sad-sounding stuff or whatever. I love that shit, man. And that album is within that vein. So is the Klaatu or the Klaatu, whatever. That as well is in the shot of a picture of the Klaatu album. Whoop. That album is really cool too, because it's so fucking strange in a good way. I'm like, yes, that's what I'm trying to look for more. Trying to find cool albums like that. You know, like, I get that there's what's the name of that one band that's, like, popular right now is fucking, like I said, King Crimson's very popular. Actually, we're still making music until recently, I think. I think they released their last album or something, like, yesterday. It sounded instrumental in a way. I don't know, I didn't give a whole listen. And then, like, Captain Beefheart and shit like that. Like, I love that, but I don't know about those two bands because I haven't really investigated it yet. Kind of one of those things where when it's popular, everyone thinks they need to, like, oh, look at me, I'm new and different. I like this song. I like King Crimson. No one else does. It's like a fucking thing. That's why I try to steer away from it, so I don't even seem like I'm part of that crowd. But Savory Brown, I've never heard of. Never heard of them. I I'm not saying I discovered something no one heard. It's just I've never heard of it. I've never heard that. I never looked for blues, so I probably could have, but I never let myself because I kind of stayed away from the blues for some reason. But man, that was really cool. It was a cool experience. Yeah, man. I wish I could type it in and look up, but I kind of want to keep it a mystery. I got to find their next album. That's what I got to do. I just saw, like, on the the sleeve that the album comes in, it showed a couple of their albums. And they looked, the same vein as that drawing. That's all I know about them. I know they have more out there, and they're weird album covers, but awesome. Fucking covers. Like, I think the next one, I don't know if it's the next one, but I know another one, something about Train to Hell or something. I don't know. Let me go get that. Find out. Let's discover something we didn't know. Bitch. Yes, so like see how it shows like albums. Oh my god, the smell. They got one called Looking In. That's freaky looking. This is how you're supposed to find music, man. Perhaps. Looks like they got one called, is that them? Chilliwack? Where's that one I saw that looked fucking awesome? With some Rolling Stones. Tight. Wow. Ooh, yeah. Yeah. The Moody Blues. That looks awesome. That fucking album cover. Whoa. Let It Bleed. Rolling Stones. There it is, Savory. There's their album that I already have. The one right there, that's fucking killer looking. Here's another one of theirs. Right? It's like sweet. It's really cool. Really, really cool. So definitely gonna keep an eye out for them. Look at that fucking band, Metamorphosis. What? Yeah, I love 60s, dude. Because it was so fresh, man. Like, now it's like, sounds so weird that you can get so much junk, you know? It's too exposed, overexposed and commercialized, as George would say. But yeah, I'm going to get that one. That'll be cool. Train to Hell. Yeah, man. I'll wear that. I'm excited. Keep an eye out for him. I'll probably go maybe one of these days. There. But I want to just talk about that for a minute. For 20 minutes to be exact. The experience of finding good music. Because it was in the same vein as the podcast I just did on Billy's channel. It was... Yes, sir. It was in the same vein about finding something. I think I was mentioning Blockbuster and how everyone felt about that. And it's true. So true. Finding realness within it. You know. Because the internet, like, I... Bam, YouTube's open. And just look. My YouTube, I hate my experiences. All the videos they suggest to me, I don't want to watch. And I only have... How many subscriptions do I have? I have 20 descriptions. Subscriptions. And I might have to phase them out again because I'm getting sick of it. Some of them, ugh. Yucks, is how I feel. So yeah, I do tend to purge my subscriptions. They get smaller and smaller. But I don't want to find a world within YouTubes or with the internet. I don't want to find a group of people there. I want to find physically going out into the world. Oops. And finding this kind of stuff. It was fun. It's like when you go to the Salvation Army or the Goodwill and you find something really cool. Like I found a typewriter once. You know, that's what it's about. It's about going there and finding a treasure. Like how I found Limbo. Or like, I found a lot of little trinkets. I talked about that story, how I found the fantasy book. That was cool. Found that. What else did I find? All those tapes that we're using to record. Happen chancely, I bought them at a Goodwill. They're just sitting there, 49 cents each. Why wouldn't you buy that if you thought you needed it? I bought that and that cassette recorder, like, at a Goodwill. That's the cool thing, man. No fucking sitting on the internet like, okay, I'm gonna type it in, I'm gonna find this and that. That recorder costs you $5 on the internet. Some people are selling for 30 because they're stupid. That's how dumb people are, trying to make a profit. And like, fuck them. You know what I mean? People are like, ooh, that's expensive. Ooh, I found it. I found a cool album. I'm gonna look it up, see how much it should cost. All right, I'm gonna sell for $30. You know, like, fuck those people. Fuck them. I hate that shit. Life's a fucking price for them. Two things that would be really cool to find: some old school headphones and an old school camera. Even if it's like with the film, with the, my mother has a Browning camera, you know, those ones you wind up and they don't, you don't record sound. It's like, oh, I think they call that Brownie. I don't remember. Brownie camera? I don't know, because it's like a brown square, really. And, I want to get one of those old school ones, man, that doesn't record sound. That would be fucking awesome, from like the 70s. Something like, they're like, yeah, you know, it's cheaper just to not record sound. Just, that would be really, really cool. It's just finding the film for it would be a bit of a process in this modern era. But because it's on the internet. Or like an old school, like 90s old school or 80s, like chunk that you set in your shoulder and it can do that stuff. I found one like for a cameraman, but it was on the internet. You get the guy to get the VHS tapes and pop those bad boys in. You know, and I couldn't find the VHS tapes for that one. So it's iffy. It's hit or miss. Or like Billy said, the battery situation. When the batteries drain, how do you get a new battery for it? He had a really good idea how we'll figure it out. But that's in part of the album that we're doing. We're trying to get a hold of that. So I have to go. I looked at the... it was a Salvation Army. Now it's a Goodwill in a city not far from me. And they had two cameras that I'm like, maybe. But I want to go and look at other places and see what they have. There's even a couple camera shops near me, but I don't know if they'd have retro cameras. And if they do, they probably like cost stupid amount of money. Ooh. Oh. So yeah, I wanted to just kind of have an update because I haven't done one of those in a few days. Where am I? What am I doing? I want to talk to you about UFOs. I gotta take a shit soon, I can feel it. That's the third one, man. Because I'm actually eating food. I haven't been doing that for a few days because I'm feeling chubby. You know how that goes. I've starved myself. Even though you're not. It's exercise! I've been feeling the itch of writing, but I'm getting back into doing what I fucking want to do. For so long I wasn't, like... I like listening to albums, man. I like doing that. I like reading books. That's so fun. I love it. Why am I not doing that enough? So I kind of been doing that stuff the past few days, just enjoying what I want to do. Read the book that you love, you know? You're reading that series by Robert Jordan. Let's keep going, bro. Because I put it down and been focusing on things, but I think today... I don't think he's got a hold of me yet. Oh, he did. 3 o'clock. Gonna go and... try to put some more vocals on the song that we're working on right now. We're just like I think I've said it before, we're demoing an album we're working on. It might be a double fucking dub album, but da-da-da-da. So we're just doing that stuff, and let's get that light in there just to piss people off. So that's kind of been what's going on there. I have, let's see how many more days before I have to go back to work. About a week and a half before I have to go back to work. So, I want to enjoy these next few days as much as I can. Over 3 months off, man. Much, much needed. I'm going to go back there. I'm going to step down from being a manager because fuck that. Because I don't want to do that shit. I'm making a dollar more. No. Nah. It's not worth it. I'm going to do that, and I'm just going to... Hopefully 4 a.m. shift. 4 a.m. to noon. Perfect shift. Just go in there. Work that shit. Then when other things start opening up, I'll step down to part-time there, and I'll do other jobs. Like, it's... I'm in a transition, man, because I cannot handle doing those stupid fucking jobs. It's so a waste of fucking life. Going to a building you don't want to be in to save up money that you may or may not need and use. It's a pointless life. So pointless. So I'm going to do that. Go back there. Keep what I got. Because I worked for that stuff and I don't want to lose it. Keep that health coverage, because it's illegal if you don't have health coverage. Because the way the world works, right? I want to, keep that in mind. Just do that job. Start stepping away from it slowly and with honor. I don't just quit, anymore. I did it twice, but those are fast food jobs, and fuck them, because that's how they make you feel. But I'm stepping away from this job with honor. I'm not just gonna walk away because it's too tough. I have to see it through. But during that time, we'll be recording music and enjoying myself, doing what I want to do. Because for so many years I wasn't. It's so weird to talk about, but for so many years I wasn't doing what I wanted to do. I was doing what everyone else wanted me to do to make them happy. That's all I was doing. And I'm tired of doing that. It is 12:22 right now. And it's 11:11 on my camera. But, so that's what I'm trying to do. I'm sick of it. And it's been nice. And you might hurt people's feelings, because you're not doing what they want, but fuck them, you kind of have to. I think what I'm going to do, like I said, just do the job that you got to do, but also balance out the music and the writing. I've talked about it before. I've taken a break from writing, just because it's to charge the battery, just be fresh, find something. And the longer the break is, the more I can take in the world around me and realize, like, man, you're onto something. Keep going. And the more I'm seeing, like, how do I word this? The more I'm noticing you're too hard on yourself. That was a good idea. You don't need to over... It's fine. Like, it's just... You gotta take a step back and look at the whole thing. Because you get... When you get caught up, you get into the Zoom, and you're looking around, you forget that, like, oh shit, like, everything's out here too. So, I've been able to kind of take a step back and realize I'm making something really fucking good. It's, like, really good. And, definitely keep, busting your ass on it, but also don't be too hard on yourself. Realize that you are doing something good, and you're onto something. So that break has been very helpful in that. I think between doing that kind of stuff and, like I said, the music, which, yesterday, let me get it out. Ow. Yesterday, I was listening to the demo. God damn, just come here. Cut my nails, so I don't have any nails. I was listening to the demo, and I was just kind of working on lyrics and stuff like that. I laid down some, like, raw lyrics to work with today, because it's at a session of a song that there's a lot of emotion, and I might have to, like, scream through it, just belt. And, I'm not a big fan of, like, letting out like that, but what it did was writing these lyrics, I read them out and I realized it's about me not wanting to have that shitty life and not wanting to go to work and being a 9-to-5 guy and retiring and at my worst time feeling like shit and then just wasting my life away. Like, I didn't want to deal with that, and that's what the song's about. And the more I thought about that, and I was, getting myself mentally prepared to put myself in this album, the more I'm realizing that the album that's happening, that we're working on, me and Billy are working on, is At least on my end, me. It's my life, how I feel. It's what I'm going through right now. And feeling the emotions from that is where I'm like, you need to capture yourself in this song. You need to capture yourself in this album, who you are. Be yourself, put it in on tape, and then for it will be forever. Say what you want to say. Say how you feel in your most raw state, because lyrics are very raw. It's not very concise. I mean, you can be, but my approach is to be very raw with the lyrics and very primal and stuff like that. Not explain in great detail. That's what the channel's for. That's what this is about. That's where I'll explain in great detail how I feel, but the lyrics are going to be raw. So I've noticed that with the song, that's what I'm doing. I'm writing my piece, you know, the piece of who I am. That's kind of what's got to happen, I guess, because what else am I going to do? It's not phony. It's not an album trying to be something. It is a concept album of a guy, but I might be the guy, or it might be Billy. Who fucking knows? Who knows who this person is? But all I know is what I'm putting in it is going to be me. It's the same as when I write. I'm not Early Cypress. I'm not Nakum. I'm not any of that, but I am at the same time. So I'm not there making their decisions, what I'm trying to say, but I am at the same time. Does that make sense? I'm writing it, but I'm not living it like they are. That's what the music is too. This guy's going through something, but so am I. And I'm about to capture how I feel about what I'm going through, the way this person's going through it. You know? Just to be loud. So that's kind of my update for my little absence. Not like it mattered, but I've just been enjoying. I've just been enjoying stuff. You know? Sometimes life gets a little tough. Sometimes it's like you just want to stop. You want to go away. You want to leave you alone. You know, and those are the times you have to know who you are and what you want so you can find happiness. That's all it is, man. That's what it's about. You gotta find your happiness. You have to find who you are and know the depths of the darkness and the light that's within you. Because I won't lie, the past few days I just been wanting to give up. You know, it's like, fuck this. Not suicide. I always try to say that. It's like, it sounds so similar, but it's really not. I don't want to die. I don't want to hurt myself. I don't like hurting people or myself, but sometimes you do want to just give up and say, fuck this, I'm out. But I got to keep going. I have to fight through it. It seems like guys are going through this around this time too, like in your 30s. You're going into your 30s or whatever, or your late 20s or something. Like, it's, you have to find your fucking purpose. You have to fight for it and get through it. Not just accept that shitty fucking job. Well, I mean, they pay me and I get 401k and I got benefits. And I'm like, no, you cannot do that. You have to fight through it. That's all I'm at. I guess you're watching someone try to go through their stupid problems so they can triumph into their art. And that's what this channel is catching. It's the purpose of it. Hopefully maybe someone will watch and say, fuck, if that fucking idiot can do it, then I must be able to do it too. But anyway, this is going to be a short vidja because I have to listen to those lyrics and I have to work on them more. You should record yourself doing that. I just, you know, no, not yet. it sounds professional, but the way I'll do it is very unprofessional. So with that being said, I'm going to call it quits on this one. And I'm going to upload this video and I'm going to just work on that song. Listen to another album, have a shower, and get ready to go out and record some music. So that's what it's about. Get them devil horns and there you go. Anyway, but until next time.